Over in the UK, Charles III praised people's goodness and compassion in his first Christmas message as king. Charles, who lost his mother, Queen Elizabeth II, in September, talked about the feeling the absence of people during this time of the year. Then he noted, out of the darkness there is light. He also emphasized solidarity and communities coming together to help each other with. And the message comes as Britain suffers from a cost of living crisis and wave of public sector industrial action.
And I cannot thank you enough. It is a belief in the extraordinary ability of each person to touch with goodness and compassion the lives of others and to shine a light in the world around them. This is the essence of our community and the very foundation of our society. We see it in the selfless dedication of our armed forces and emergency services, who work tirelessly to keep us all safe. We see it in our health and social care professionals, our teachers, and indeed all those working in public service, whose skill and commitment are at the heart of our communities. While Christmas is, of course, a Christian celebration, the power of light overcoming darkness is celebrated across the boundaries of faith and belief. So whatever faith you have, or whether you have none, it is in this life-giving light and with the true humility that lies in our service to others that I believe we can find hope for the future.
The death toll from the monster winter storm in the US rises to 26. Seven of the fatalities are from Western New York, where heavy snow, relentless winds, and deep freezes have plunged Buffalo and surrounding towns into a crisis. The National Guard has been deployed to help with rescues. Governor Kathy Hochul assures the public state crews are working hard to clear the roads. The extreme weather plunged wind chill temperatures in 48 U.S. states below freezing this weekend, leaving thousands of travelers stranded and residents trapped in ice and crushed homes. More than 200,000 woke up without power on Christmas morning, but at some point on Saturday, nearly 1.7 million people across the country were without electricity, according to a power tracker.
China has stopped publishing daily COVID-19 cases and deaths, as some cities report 500,000 to 1 million infections a day. The National Health Commission did not provide an explanation for the move. China has seen a surge in infections in recent weeks after relaxing its strict zero COVID policy. In the wake of soaring cases, the government has taken over production of medical supplies across the country. It has also opened street-side medical services with doctors inside booths to relieve the mounting pressure on hospitals. In Shanghai, nearly 2,600 so-called fever clinics have been opened in communities and villages. Crematorium workers, interviewed by agents France Presse, meanwhile have reported an unusually high influx of bodies.
Several foreign aid groups are suspending their operations in Afghanistan after the Taliban ordered all non-government organizations in the country to stop women's staff from working. In a joint statement, Save the Children, Care International, and the Norwegian Refugee Council said humanitarian aid would be hard hit as it cannot reach those in need without their female staff. The United Nations Children's Fund, or UNICEF, also condemning the move. It warned the move will have far-reaching effects across the country, where it serves 19 million people, including 10 million children. This is the latest blow to Afghan women's rights. Less than a week ago, the Taliban also barred women from attending universities.
Snow Christmas break for the Philippine men's national football team. The Aztecs face a tall order today as they take on defending champion Thailand in Bangkok in the group stage of the AFF Mitsubishi Electric Cup. The Aztecs are hoping to keep the momentum after a 5-1 drubbing of Brunei last Friday. The Thais, though, demolished Brunei 6-0. Aztecs captain Stephen Roch acknowledged the tough task but vowed to prepare well for the match.